Hi, I'm the Alchemist Astrologer, and this is your Pisces new moon reading for the sign of Gemini. This new moon heralds a new beginning for you related to 10th house matters. So for some of you, the focus is on your success, your career, your ambitions. It could be your role as an authority figure, a leader, or perhaps you're dealing with people of influence. And for some of you, this may have to do with your credit, your reputation, or dealing with parents. Now, in the past, you have the Justice card. And so for some of you, there may be ties to a Libra person. This could be their sun, their moon, or their rising. Or you're focused on making an important decision, or you were. Now, for some of you, this may tie to the legal system. You may be connecting with attorneys or judges or looking at some type of representation. For others of you, this is a decision that requires some measure of balance. You're trying to restore order to a situation. It could be making a choice between two options. Maybe these are two opportunities, two partners. You're making decisions, and there's a strong focus on fairness, justice. So for some of you, you may be examining your own conscience, or perhaps you are focused on settling a debt, whether that is financial or emotional. But there is some type of revelation that comes to light, a revelation about a decision that you need to make. Now, currently, you're dealing with the Wheel of Fortune. So there's been a change in your circumstance for better or for worse. This may tie to vehicles, to actual wheels, to travel, to money, to gambling. Perhaps you've taken a risk and you find yourself in a set of circumstances that feels to be very fated, when in fact, something that you recently said or did has set this wheel in motion, and again, for better or for worse. Now, there could be some luck running through a circumstance. You just need to see it. Something that you consider to be insignificant may play a major role in a situation. This may be a turn of events that affected something connected to a romance or something that you had romanticized. Now, in the future, you have the King of Pentacles. This is Earth energy. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female, or just the traits of this king. Now, this King of Pentacles is very concerned, of course, with earthly matters, the material, and that could be a focus. You're making some changes, some decisions that may have a legal element to it, connected to real estate, property, finances, investments, banking. You may be dealing with people involved in the finance industry. This is a period where you're going to want to establish something and put it on firm footing, whether that's a project, a property, or a relationship. This is a king who is the provider. So you may be very focused on providing for your family, a loved one, or vice versa. And for some of you, this King of Pentacles is negative. This is someone who is totally materialistic and his entire focus is on acquisition. So there's some greediness, some selfishness, placing the material far above his relationships and what is really important in life. So that could have set a change in motion that uprooted the scales. So for some of you, you may be trying to restore the balance in some bad luck or change your fortune, or you've made a decision that proves fortunate. If this is a case of a romance or a relationship, perhaps you're spending more time alone. Something came to light, or perhaps you set a chain of events off that ended where you ended up being alone. Or perhaps you are alone with someone that you have a romantic interest in. So the King of Pentacles wants to establish something. So for some of you, you're making an important decision, taking a risk that may or may not pay off for you financially and emotionally. Your advice card is dig deeper. So again, you may have received some kind of revelation. Perhaps you're making a decision to try to find something out, getting some facts, some figures, some information. But for many of you, you're looking inside of yourself. There's a need to dig deeper. Perhaps you made a choice that didn't turn out exactly as you hoped, and you feel a sense of dissatisfaction. And rather than projecting it out onto a person or a circumstance, you're having to look at what it is that's really at the root of why you're not happy. All right, I hope you enjoyed this reading. Remember, if you'd like a far more personal reading, you can visit my website to schedule an appointment.